Get this and then circle around. Basically the same concept. There's a little too much weight on the bottom.
carried on so long, you couldn't stop if you tried it. You built your wall so high.
On behalf of Alex and Jessica, thank you all for being here today to make this day memorable for them. Today is more than just a ceremony. It is an act of worship where we celebrate the joining of two believers in biblical marriage. Today is the day that you two have been longing for, and many of your family and your friends have been praying and waiting for. Please be seated. Today, who gives Jessica to be married to Adam? Today it is my honor to be a part of what God is doing in your life. I think it's clear to see how both of you are uniquely crafted for each other. We're here today because we believe in what God is doing in your life. We believe that God is doing in your life what only He can do. And we believe that God is being glorified in and through this relationship. Today, you're taking a step, the next step in your journey, with one another, moving toward a bond of commitment and eternal covenant. God tells us that marriage between two believers is a covenant. It is unbreakable. It is a bond between a husband and a wife, with God as the center and the witness of your marriage vows. Today, you will pledge your love to one another in the sight of God, your family, and your friends. Many here today have had the privilege of watching you two grow up and grow into the man and the woman that you are today. I think it's important to note that both Alex and Jessica made the commitment to countless hours of premarital counseling, not because something was wrong, but because they wanted to do everything they could to ensure that they were equipped for a long and prosperous journey together. You two have greatly impacted each other's lives. You have learned to love in both the good and the challenging times. You have seen the best and what you think is the worst. And each of you yet still remain with love that is stronger than ever. The love between a husband and a wife is one of the greatest gifts that God can give to us all. Someone to spend our lives learning to love and loving to learn more about each and every day. 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Paul describes for us what true love is. Love is supposed to be like, you know, how it's challenging and a model for us today in the Word of God. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoice with truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Ultimately, love never ends. Our foundation for what marriage looks like was patterned for us after the love that God has for us. God's love is unconditional. God's love is sacrificial. God's love is enduring. Jesus unconditionally loved us despite our sins, and showed us his love by sacrificing his earthly life for our sins. And now David, he walks with us. And if your marriage is going to last, it can only last as you surrender yourself to a loving and gracious God with all your heart, your mind, your soul, and your strength. Alex and Jessica, you made a very serious and important decision to choose to marry each other today. You're entering into a sacred covenant. The quality of your marriage will reflect what you put into nurturing this relationship. So today, Alex, do you accept the responsibility and do you promise before God and these witnesses to love Jessica, comfort her, honor her, lead her, provide, and protect her, keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others and to keep yourself only unto her, so long as both of you shall live. And likewise, Jessica, do you accept this responsibility? Do you promise before God and these witnesses to love Alex, to comfort him, to honor him, keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, and keeping yourself only unto him as long as both of you shall live? Now it has come time to proclaim your vows before God, family, and friends. These are not only words to be spoken out, but vows to be lived each and every day.
I'm giving you this ring with the promise to be the best husband and father that I can be, with trust, love, and devotion. I know I won't always be perfect. I might forget to listen, forget to share. I might not always agree, and I might be stubborn and bullheaded, but I will always love you. Even despite my shortfalls, I promise to strive to be the man you believe I can be. I promise not only to listen, but to hear, be honest, trust you, consider your thoughts and feelings as we go on this journey in life together. I promise to be there to catch you when you stumble, to make my life yours. I promise to build my dream around you. You're my other half. Probably my better half. You always know the right thing to cheer me up when I'm sad. You make me stop and consider when I'm being too rash. And you find me when I'm lost. You are my dreams come true. And I am truly grateful and humbled at this gift God has given me. I'm in awe that I'm standing here about to start the rest of my life. You should know that I think you look as beautiful to me as you ever have standing here today, and you look as beautiful to me tomorrow and every day for the rest of our lives. I promise always to be your best friend, to have fun and enjoy life with you. I promise to always laugh with you. And most importantly, I promise never to forget these vows I made to you. Now really quick, I'd like to quote one of the greatest philosophers of the 20th century. He said, we're all a little weird, and life's a little weird. So when we find someone whose weirdness is compatible with ours, we join up with them and fall in mutual weirdness. And then we call it love. And I think that's a perfect way to define our relationship. It's Dr. Seuss, by the way. You're just my right kind of weird. People are always looking for that perfect person to call their wife. Some people never find that. But I'm one of the lucky ones. I found you.
Loving me like you both do. And you taught me a kind of love that I've never encountered before. And for that, I promise to love and encourage you both as you grow older. I promise to always read bedtime stories and sing songs with you before you fall asleep at night. Grace, I promise to always crank the music and sing at the top of my lungs in the car with you. I promise to forever be your favorite hairstyle and to always remind you just how beautiful you are inside and out. Noah, I promise to never stop learning from you. You are so full of adventure and eagerness to learn. And you also have just the biggest heart, and I have never met a more intelligent and sweet 7-year-old. And I cannot wait to watch you grow and see where life takes you. And to my best friend and my biggest fan, I promise to love you deeply and unconditionally. I promise to put your needs above all others and support and stand by you through every dream that you choose. I promise to always make you smile and laugh, because among the infinite number of things that I love about you, your smile. promise to always be patient and kind and honest with you. I promise to be your place of comfort and safety in troubling times, a place you can always let your guard down. I promise to cherish and appreciate you no matter what comes our way, because I know that we are both stronger than we possibly could be apart when we're together. I promise to never stop telling you that your eyes look like sunflowers on a sunny day, even when you roll your eyes at me. But most importantly, I promise to love you, Noah, and Grace wholeheartedly and unmistakably for as long as I live.
Today, you will exchange rings as a token of your love for each other. These rings are a sign of your vow, your commitment, and your love for one another. Jessica, when you receive this ring from Alex as a symbol of his love for you, when you wear it as a sign of your affection, your faithfulness towards him.
I will.
Alex, if you have to meet. With this ring, I be with.
I be with.
And with all of my worldly goods,
all of my worldly goods,
all of my life,
all of my life,
all of my love,
all of my love,
I now give to you.
And I give to you.
In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
the Son,
the Son,
and the Holy
Spirit.
And Alex, will you receive this ring from Jessica as a symbol of her love for you, and will you wear it as a sign of your affection and faithfulness towards her?
I will.
With this ring, I be with.
I be with.
And with all of my worldly good.
With all my worldly good.
All of my life.
All of my life.
All of my love.
All of my love.
I now give to you.
I now give to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
Son.
Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Alex and Jessica will now do the unity stand. Today, you joined your separate lives together. The two separate bottles of sand symbolize your separate lives, your separate families, and your separate sets of dreams. They represent all that you are and all that you will ever be as individuals. They also represent your lives together. As these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist. They will be joined together as one. Just as you drain the sand from every separation and pour it in the individual containers, so will your marriage. Father, today, we have witnessed the joining together of these two individuals. We love, their honor, their respect, but most of all, their God. Father, we pray countless blessings upon them. We pray that they continue to grow and to learn and to love each other more and more each and every day of their life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Alex and Jessica, now that you have given yourselves to each other, by your promises before God, family, and friends. It is my honor today as a minister of the gospel and in accordance to the laws of North Carolina, do pronounce you I now pronounce Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time, and if you all could grab your bubbles, I would like to pronounce Mr. and Mrs. Alex and Jessica Nasseli.
It's 104 Court Street, Bay Court, North Top Sail Island. But we'll have food and just a good time to get together. Love to see everybody out there.